Okay, to summarize the constructive pericarditis criteria with a specificity of 91% and sensitivity of 87% is that you see for the septal dependence first. There are many reasons for septal dependence. Even the severe pulmonary hypertension can have the septal always deviating towards the LV, or severe LV diastolic systolic dysfunction can have always septum deviated towards the right septum, right ventricle, or but it will not be varying much with the respiratory variation. The respiratory variation of septal motion abnormality is more confirmatory of constrictive pericarditis. Then is the mitral inflow pattern velocity. That is, restrictive pattern is seen and there is a inspiratory variation of the mitral inflow pattern of more than 25% decrease in the inspiration across the mitral inflow is confirmatory of constrictive pericarditis. Then is the medial E dash or the septal E dash, you can calculate, that is the annulus E dash will be more than 8 when compared to the lateral, because lateral may be less because of the attachment of the muscle to the pericardium. So medial E dash is more than 8 cm per second in the presence of restrictive pattern of velocity in the mitral inflow in itself is a confirmatory that it's a constrictive pericarditis. And then the most specific parameter of constrictive pericarditis is the hepatic vein diastolic flow reversal with expiration. So in inspiration there are two waves always, that is, one is systolic and another one is diastolic, systolic diastolic. But as the expiration starts, there is only a systolic wave, there is a diastolic flow reversal. The DR wave will be seen prominent or bifid in the expiratory phase of the hepatic vein, and it's a diastolic reversal. That is, the systolic wave is intact, it is going towards the heart, but in the diastolic wave actually should go towards the heart, but it is going away from the heart because of the sudden constriction or restriction of movement, sudden constriction of the pericardium and sudden collapse of blood moving towards the ventricle in the mid systole. So in the diastolic phase it will not accommodate any of the blood and it will reverse in the veins. It is called hepatic diastolic flow reversal in expiration.